And you write, co-produce, arrange,
whatever it has to be done, you know.
Sounds good. So you're also reaching back in the community and helping.
Definitely, I think that's very, very important to reach back and help someone instead of just going on off. You know, I figure if you help someone, then when you finish doing your thing, they'll accept you a little more knowing that you helped someone.
How did you get started out of D.C., especially with rap? Because I think a lot of people don't stereotype D.C. as a city with a lot of rappers, in which
When I started, it was like 1987. I did a rap called Stone Cold Hustler. It started as a joke, really. It started as telling my friends, yo, I'm gonna do this. I wanna make a record. And they laughed, go to class, you know. Stop playing.
Is that McKinley?
Yeah.
McKinley,
so, I did it to just have some fun and have the fellas go, oh man, you did it. You know, and it became a public demand for me to do something else. So I had to continue on. I got started at a club. Chapter 3. This is way before it got rough. They had a rap contest down there, and I was the only guy from D.C. in the rap contest. And I went down there, and I did my thing, and they really liked it. The crowd responded well.
So how long did it take you to get your record pressed then? From it becoming an idea then going to wax?
I'll say about a month afterwards. The record company that I dealt with then was Colossal Records, and they said that I had something really hot that needed to be out there, so we sat down and did negotiations, and we pressed it and had it out there.
Now, your record was very big in D.C., and where else?
Parts of New York, California, New Jersey, Texas, different spots, you know, that are into playing rap music, because most radio stations nowadays, they don't play rap
music.
So rap has to branch off into new space, you know, R&B, rap mixed with jazz, you know. Rap is here to stay.
That's true, but your rap is like a positive type of rap music. What would you say to those other brothers out there who aren't doing
it? I'll never knock no one for doing what they want to do with their music and their lyrics. That's what they want to do. My thing is to project a very positive image for our youngsters coming up, because they listen to rap music, you know, before they would do their homework. You know,
That's true.
They get into rap music. Rap music is, per se, a way of communication as far as the young black youth is concerned. I figure if I'm going to communicate with them, communicate on a point where they'll understand that this is how they should do it. They should do it right, and they should do it where it's positive, because there's already so much negative things going on with our youngsters today. And I'm not saying it like I'm old, you know, but right. There's so much stuff going on that we need more positive than we need negative to overcome.
Was it because of the situation in D.C. at the time that you started out with Stone Cold Hustler?
Definitely, because I write music from what I see and what I experience. And at the time, that's what I was seeing and experiencing at the time. So that's what I made my subject about.
So do you actually, like, live what you say? Do you believe in what you're rapping about?